This video is made possible by Atlas VPN. Another Bijay Shahi video. I'm so sorry. I swear this is the last thing I ever utter about Bijay Shahi. Okay, I've wasted enough time on this guy. Goodness me. All right, here's a story. I didn't even think I'd make a reaction video. I thought I'd just put my last interview out and that would be that.
Nope.
But there has been an uproar. And honestly, I can't thank you guys enough. All those viewers, you know, I really was happy that I put the video out there for you to judge, and collectively, you guys figured it out. All right, let me just come out and say it. I got scammed by Bijay Shahi. I did. I'm not gonna pretend like I didn't. He got me. He got me good. But with all of your reactions, you helped me kind of reassess and review what happened in the interview. And a lot of the things you guys are saying are, I think, in the right direction. I don't know if it's as simple as you guys make it sound. There's some things that are wrong with your ideas or theories of what happened, but there are specific things that I can prove, and I will prove it in this video, that without a doubt show that this was a scam and that Bijay is full of crap. For those of you who are new to this channel, welcome. I typically don't just focus on scam artists or people who claim to have good memories, although I do react occasionally to those kinds of things. Usually you'll find memory tips and helpful things. So from now on, we're going back to that. And if you're a new subscriber, thank you. You will see more of that content coming up. And to bring you up to speed, there's this guy, Bijay Shahi. He called himself the Memory King. He claimed to do these crazy things where he could memorize a book in 10 minutes. And he's been outed, been called a scam artist, a fraud. I reacted to one of his videos and invited him for an interview. I could challenge him and figure out if he's real or not. Anyways, I happened to be in Nepal recently. We did the interview. I posted the interview. It did not sit well with most people. And I try to keep myself as non-biased as possible, just an interviewer asking questions, observing what he's doing, and let you guys make the decision. But I have some things to say. I have specific evidence that undeniably shows that Bijay, what he did in the interview, that it's a complete show, it's a scam, it's a whole act. But first, let's go over some of the theories and ideas that some people have had in the comments, because they're very good and probably very close to the truth. So I'm using footage from Misguided Nepal, right, which is a channel that has posted a really well edited video analyzing my interview. And we're gonna go through the points that this person makes and what I think about them, maybe give a little more context. I wanna provide all the information that is out there. I like to play devil's advocate, so everybody can have all the information or as much information as possible before they make their final decision. But first, let's talk about this video sponsor. Since this video is all about being scammed and being possibly hacked, sort of, I wish that I had a way to protect myself. And that might translate to how you might want to protect yourself on the internet. So let me tell you a little bit about Atlas VPN. It's a great tool to keep your stuff private online and stay anonymous on the web. On top of that, they got a great discount going on right now, so make sure to check out the link in the description. Now, if you're not using a VPN, then you're no better than me getting scammed by Bijay Shahi in this video. Now, Atlas VPN encrypts all the data you send, but it's also a great help for real life, everyday situations. For example, you know, accessing geo-blocked libraries on streaming platforms like Netflix, Amazon, Prime, Hulu, HBO, and more to avoid censorship when you're traveling abroad, and in general, just to increase your security on public internet connections. So for example, I like to watch Top Gear. It's one of my favorite shows, but it's only available for streaming on Netflix UK. I'm in the US, so I use my VPN just like this to get access to the library available on Netflix UK, and voila, there is my Top Gear. Also, they got this great feature called Data Breach Monitor. The tool scans the internet to see if your email ended up in any recorded data breaches or data dumps that included emails, names, passwords, and other sensitive information. Pretty cool. Currently, Atlas VPN is running a huge discount on their 3-year deal for just $139 per month with a 30-day money-back guarantee. The deal won't last for long, so make sure to check it out by clicking the link in the video description below. And now back to the video where we prove that Bijay Shahi is a phony. Let's dive in. The woman in the video somehow switched out the papers. She recorded it and wrote the answer and then somehow swapped it when I wasn't looking. Now, I'll say before anything, this is very possible that it happened. I'm not ruling it out, but I will provide some reasons why maybe some of that might have been more challenging than you as a viewer might think. But I definitely, there's one thing, and nobody's actually brought this up, there's one thing that to me makes this entire thing look super fishy. And it's not the girl, it's not the tears on the paper. I'll show you what it is. But I want to address a couple things that I'm seeing here from this person's commentary. So he says here that, you know, the divine power is a lot of what Bijay explains his powers or skills to be. And here they're saying that that's actually not quite what he said in past interviews. I didn't know that. Very interesting to me. If I knew that, I would have drilled him a little harder on that question. I don't like that answer. It doesn't sit well with me. It's such a cop-out. Like, come on. Also, another person said that when I asked him, when did you realize you had this power? And he said, 2 years. I thought he meant since he was 2 years old, which would have been a little more reasonable. Okay, it's a God-given gift. Great. Okay, you were born with it. Cool. But I think from my misunderstanding, it's actually 2 years ago, which to me is absurd. Like, you don't just, unless you're hit in the head by a baseball bat, your brain somehow gets injured, that you suddenly realize you have this ability. It doesn't happen like that. So that already is another annoying red flag. All right, one thing about this lady, she didn't really speak good English. We barely interacted. She gave me or offered me coffee here, brought me a water, brought her food. She seemed to be the assistant of his office. But I will say they were very hospitable, right? All she's doing here seemingly is being a nice host, right? Bringing me coffee, bringing me water. That's a nice thing to do, right? I didn't think anything of it when I was in the room. Another thing to note, people were saying, you know, they had a plan, they were gonna record what he said. But let me remind you, here's one of my counter arguments, if you will. They didn't know I was gonna do a single page, right? You could see from the interview that they thought that I was gonna ask to do the entire book. Now, there's no way Bijay was gonna sit there reading the entire book from start to finish out loud, right? That would have taken at least 10 hours, okay? And if she was recording the whole thing, how are they gonna know how to find the page I was gonna ask them about, right? Now, they may have had another plan planned out in the case that I did that. Who knows, right? But for those of you saying that they had this figured out, I know he steps away from the room for a little bit, but is that enough time to say like, hey, let's do plan B? Or did they have this planned out in some capacity? They just said, let's do that scam B, the one that we talked about before in case he asked this, blah, blah, blah. I don't know. It seems pretty tough to have figured out a way to do this with me right there in the room. That's pretty ballsy. But you know, if he's a true scam artist, if he's a true illusionist magician kind of guy, these kind of people are well prepared on how to fool people. So who knows, perhaps. Now we see she takes out a phone here, it's black. Now one thing the guy says in this video, hang on, is that she puts it by the sink. I don't think this really matters, but I don't think she did put it by the sink because watch, you can see here, you can see in the corner here that she's putting something in her back pocket. I would assume it's her phone. Again, it doesn't matter if the phone's there, you know, she could have recorded it from in the room, from just outside the room when the door was closed, I don't know. But just to point that out, that I don't know if that's quite accurate, what this person is saying. And here, even if you were to look, I think in her backside pocket, you can actually see the outline of the phone. So I think the phone is on her. Again, does that really make a difference? I don't think so, but just to point that out. Now, I do remember when this was happening, I was like, come on, dude, why are you getting out of the room so many times? What are you up to now? And then when he came back with a little Kalima trinket, I was like, okay, he's playing on this religious thing. This is important to him. I don't know, but it was uncomfortable for me to see him get out of the room so much. I didn't like that. I was like, what is he planning, you know? And he could have very well been talking to the girl saying, hey, just record this and try to write it out and get it to me. I don't know how he would have, maybe they had some signals prepared, but I don't know how he would have let her know with the door closed when to pass through the paper, right? How did she know I was looking the other way? That kind of thing. I mean, he was very verbal in what he was saying. Could have been heard through the door, but you know, there's a lot of things, right, to plan, just saying. Now, one thing I will say is I did think it was weird that he talked out loud. And what's funny is if you were to go with the conjecture that the woman recorded him and wrote it out based on what she heard, that makes sense for the mistakes that he's made here. Like, for example, in the first line, it says, when he felt the mountain, right? This translated to when his field the mountain.
When he failed the mountain.
So, you know, there's things that he would have said or pronounced incorrectly that got translated kind of actually how it was written down, which is a pretty good sign that it was recorded and somebody wrote down what they heard. Now, on the flip side, if you listen to what he says and you compare it to what he wrote or she wrote, some of the words he said are missing. Or they're different. So that kind of throws a wrench into that idea that she was listening to a recording and writing out what she heard, because how can she write out stuff that isn't there? Unless it's done on purpose to give the effect that it's not perfect. You know what I mean? But have a listen, right?
Sure. Yeah,
you could do this.
Yeah, this one, 269.
With a bottle in each hand's way.
First of all, hands. Instead of he wrote, this person wrote hand. If you heard hands like you did there, you would have written the S, no?
When he felt the mountain seeped underneath him, the wall of rocks probing.
The wall of rocks, he says, right? But here it says the wall rock. Okay.
Of the downhill side of the tent was collapsing. The tent.
He said was collapsing. And that doesn't even show here. It says of washing, cry flying, or whatever this says. So of washing, where did that come from, right? Why would that person have written that? If it's pretty clear, like if you didn't see the video and you were hearing that, you wouldn't write of washing, right? I don't know. I'm not saying that that's not the way they did it, but maybe it's more than that. Maybe it's a little different, or maybe it's not that exact scam, right? Just a different scam. Next, let's talk about the paper that I rip. Okay, here's what I have to say about that. When I ripped it out, you can see it's not a perfect tear, right? Now, the pages in this book had a perforated edge, right? Meaning that, you know, it's supposed to be easy to rip in a straight line. Now, I don't know, my nerves or just trying to do it fast enough, I didn't get it quite. So I think, and I I'm trying to remember what happened exactly, but I think that I ripped it into the seam of the book, right? Meaning the perforated edge was still there, okay? Now you can see it's clearly uneven, right? But if you look at this frame, I'm gonna screenshot it, you can actually see the perforated edge, okay? Now why is that important? Well, when he's doing his thing for the 30 minutes that I'm not looking, there's a possibility that he evened it out, right? He just pulled the paper off so that it was perfect. There is that possibility. I'm not gonna rule that out. I can see myself, I'm a perfectionist. If I saw that uneven edge and I was just kind of sitting there trying to remember something out of boredom, I could see myself very well evening out an uneven side like that. Totally reasonable. Again, I never saw it. Where did the paper go? Maybe put it in this pocket, like the shreds that came off the side. I don't know. But I agree, this is not the same jagged edge as the one of the paper that I have, right? There, it's perfectly, almost perfect here, right? So that's interesting. Also, they're talking about how I wasn't able to see the handwriting. He hid it from me. That is true, but I could see he was writing something. Do I know what it was? No. Did it look similar to what I got on the final paper? Yes, but again, I couldn't see what he was writing word for word, so who knows. More on the paper issue later. I have some really damning evidence. It just made me decide there and then that for sure, no question, this was all a scam. All right, now the next part that is a huge problem, of course, and I knew this would be a huge problem for a lot of people, and I even had a huge problem with it, of course, is that I had to turn away. At that moment, I was like, are you fucking kidding me? After all this, after so much of letting me kind of be in the process here, you're now gonna tell me to look away? That's gonna kill all credibility right there and then. And it did, right? I mean, this is, anything can happen technically in 20, 30 minutes without someone looking, right? Now, what I will tell you, for the most part, I had him in my peripheral. Again, we were in this room together. I also could hear. I was being very, very perceptive. Any chance I could get, I was looking at him in my peripheral. You can see in the video that that's not always the case. Could she have slid something under the door? Definitely. Would I have heard it? Yeah, maybe not. I, you know, like, I wasn't listening for that, right? But I do know that the door was never opened. I can tell you that much because that door made sound. And he didn't move really from where he was sitting there. So, yeah, I mean, the other question is, where did the other paper go? Maybe he just folded it and put it in his pocket. I don't know. So now here's the thing that gives away that this is most likely a scam, all right? And it has to do with the paper as well. If you look at the paper he gives me, right, there's clearly a crease down the middle where it was folded. And actually, there was another one this way too. It was folded in four. He gave it to me, okay? Over a month later, those creases are still there. Okay, you can see them, right? If I hold them in the light, there you go. You can see them easily. Now notice the corners. I don't know if you can see this, but the corners have no noticeable fold creases, right? Like when you read a book and you dog-ear the page, right? If you look at, let's see, the original page I gave him, there's a noticeable dog-ear at the bottom corner. That does not exist here. Now, the thing about paper, when you fold it, those creases do not come out. They are there for eternity. I mean, unless I'm wrong, right? Somebody prove me wrong. If you make a fold in a paper, can you get that fold out as if it had never happened? I don't think you can do that in the standard, you know, school A4 piece of paper, whatever you want to call it. Physicist out there, am I wrong? I don't care how much, you know, I've been having this paper stuck in this hardcover book pressed, right? So maybe it was massaged out. You would still see a vague line somewhere on the sheet if that was the case. I just want you to watch this, all right? I managed to find a still. I scrubbed through the footage and when he was doing the recall, writing things out on paper, and I tried to find a moment where he turned the page over and I could freeze the frame and sort of read maybe what he was writing. Because remember, I couldn't see what he was writing. Per se, I could kind of see, and it looked like he was writing. I saw ink on the page, but I couldn't tell what it was, okay? But there's this frame here. I'll play it a couple times. So he just turned it over to write again. He had taken a pause. So look, a little slower, there. Flip it over. If I stop it right here, zoom in, look at that, right? I draw a little line. That shows, I can't read what it is, right? It's still too blurry, but I can tell for sure, with certainty, 100%, that first word, and all it looks like most of the lines there that he's written so far, are a decent amount of space away from that margin line, right? Shown in red here. That is undeniable. It's not touching the line, right? There's like a little gap there. Am I crazy? No. This is what he gave me. Yeah. No gap whatsoever.
Gotcha, bitch.
Now, if you number these lines, here's another piece of evidence. I'm sure you could get a bunch out of this, but that to me speaks for itself. There's no need to go further. It's done. It is not the same sheet he gave me from the one he's writing on right now. Done and done. But if you look on line 9 here, I don't know what that word is. It looks like he wrote something like meaning or becoming. It ends in ing. I can see the g at the end there. Now, if we look at the same line on the thing he gave me, that word does not look the same as the other one. And even the g, the way he's written the g, is not the same kind of low-hanging hook, right? It's a different kind of loop. So no matter what you want to believe, you can't deny that. It's over, Bijay. It's over. You're done. Stop this crap, man. You wasted my time. I'm so angry. I'm really angry. I felt for the guy. I was too nice. I do that story of my life, but I was too nice. And this guy, he shot himself in the foot, to be honest, but there it is. Bijay is a scam artist and a fraud. Nelson Dulles, four-time USA memory champion, says so. Now, one last thing I want to talk about is his handwriting. At this point, I don't really know if it matters to even talk about this, but it is interesting nevertheless because it still makes me wonder how he did this. Again, I don't think it's as simple as he made the girl do it and she was recording. There's some inconsistencies with that, but this definitely was a scam. After I realized that you guys were right and that maybe someone else wrote this, I reached out to him immediately on Facebook to see if he would do something on camera. I recorded it, had him write out a passage that's the same from here, made him take a picture of it live on the call so I could compare the handwritings. And this is what I got. These are the two handwriting samples. They look the same, but someone else, one of you guys, actually reached out to me with handwriting samples from other previous demos he's done, and it doesn't look the same at all. His handwriting has changed. Now, there could be explanations for this. Sometimes people's handwritings change, but if this is the girl that wrote it, how can it be the same as what he just demonstrated for me? Did they train to match their handwritings? I don't know. Maybe that's not too hard, but it is something to think about, right? How do they do that? In the end, it doesn't matter. BJ is a fraud. I'm saying that definitively. No more videos about this. I'm moving on, as all of you should. Forget this clown and just move on. He's not worth anybody's time. Nepal is a beautiful country and doesn't deserve to be made a fool of by this one guy. Anyways, that's it. No more. I'm done. This is the last video. Promise. Anyways, I hope you like my content. As I said before, it'll be more memory related, helpful in the future, because believe it or not, these memory techniques are not divine powers. Anybody can do them. Yep, it's true. So please like and subscribe, please share, and I'll see you guys in the next video. I'm out.